It works on stains caused by coffee, tea, red wine, and even smoking. For those of you who have that one stain too, PowerSwabs can target that area using swab precision.
I was actually able to take the swab and then get through some of those areas that are kind of like untreated. I can immediately see the shades getting brighter and brighter, or whiter and whiter.
This new year, order PowerSwabs and receive up to 50% off, and as an added bonus, get a free quick stick pen with your order. Dial the number on your screen or visit. Happy New Year! That is why he is a legend. Let's go to Rita. What do you have for us down there, Rita?
Ryan, I'm speechless. I'm in awe. I'm like, oh, Cool Day. The ladies love it for a reason. I'm like, I'm gonna knock you out. Tough to Midnight Planet Tenders is sponsoring a very special performance from the Mama Venus herself, Megan Thee Stallion, another queen. It's time to start moving our body, yaddy, 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 yaddy. 2024 is just around the corner, here on New Year's Rockin' Eve on ABC. We're so close!
£20,000.
This year, for the first time ever, we're simulcasting on over 150 iHeartRadio stations. So hello to everyone listening to all the excitement here in New York City. There are about a million people crowding Broadway and 7th Avenue from 42nd Street all the way to Central Park. And Rita, some fellow UKers, right?
Hi, Rita.
Thank you, darling. Keeping us safe tonight, the NYPD. Thank you. Every day, every night, on the job. So a massive thanks to them and, of course, the members of our armed services.
Hopefully they fare better this year than they did last year.
Last year was, in a word, wet, but it didn't keep folks from coming to see the ball drop in person, and there are even more of them out here tonight. Somewhere in this crowd, Rita, I know you're out there. Where are you?
I'm swimming through a sea of people. I cannot believe how many people are here at Times Square. I'm so crazy. I mean, Ryan, you're used to this, but this is my first time. We are literally minutes away from midnight. We have a ball to drop. Okay, champagne to drink, mutually consented kissing to do. This is the big moment. And Ryan, actually, I can see Ryan right now racing through the crowd as we speak to take up his position so he can bring it to you live.
Okay,
but that's not all. We've still got performances, guys, to come from Megan Thee Stallion, Ellie Goulding, and Green Day. It's about to be 2024 here in Times Square with New Year's Rockin' Eve returns on ABC.
John Del Giorno and our chopper pilot, Arthur Anderson. Thanks for these spectacular shots of that crowd. They're very excited. The new year is now just minutes away. You can see the looks of awe on people's faces as they look up at the ball. Everyone will have their phones in the air. Isn't that beautiful? What a sight. It is about to rain confetti.
Put my TV remote up in the air.
Main event. Rita, paint a picture for us. Set the scene.
Oh my goodness. First of all, I found two incredible angels. Look at them. But they've both got white on and I've got black on. It's like a fit to me. You can feel the anticipation in here. Kyla, Sabrina,
I can feel something. That's for certain. Oh yeah, I was totally listening to what you were saying. Yeah, I was absolutely paying attention to what you were saying. He was tooing, clearly. Even the women are taller than him. That's gotta be intimidating. You know, it's 2024. And by someone else's calculations, approximately 3% of people are still using Windows 7. Tonight, we're gonna find out what it's like for that 3% of people out there still braving the wild using Windows 7. And for those Steam users who are all so worried about Steam ending support for Windows 7 tonight, well, my friends, we're 2 minutes in, and let's see. Steam is still here. And I don't have any games installed on this laptop, but hey, it's still running Steam anyway. So, let's take a look at Windows 7, see how usable it is, see what the browser support is like, see what the app support is like, and, well, be amazed, I suppose, because it's still perfectly fine. Spoiler alert. But, you know, here we go. Alright, son, don't be too disturbed by the explosions in the background. But here we are, Windows 7, no sugarcoating it. This is a laptop that I've recently set up. This is a HP Compaq. Actually, it's not an HP Compaq, it's an HP EliteBook, excuse me. I'm used to saying HP Compaq. This is an 8730W. I have to get used to saying that now that I own one, because I'm used to my 8710W, the precursor to this wonderful laptop here, designed for Windows 7, featuring an Intel Core 2 Duo and ATI Fire GL graphics. A perfectly capable system still today for basic computing tasks. Not so much for gaming, but of course I do have Steam on here, and I have a couple of basic games installed like this. I can hit play on that, and it'll launch it just fine. I guess it gave me an error because I'm logged in on my desktop computer in another room, but that's not related to Windows 7. So, here you go, make sure I'm recording. Yeah, I'm recording. Alright, so yeah, there's that game. Close that. And in order to demonstrate that, I will exit it and restart it here. In 2024, we're going to start up Steam in 2024. Hopefully you can see that just fine. I can see the camera's tilting down a little bit. There we go. All right. Waiting for network, logging in, loading user data, and there it is. And, oh, that's nice. Yes, obviously it's not the best experience in the world, but, you know, never mind that. In addition to the explosions, of course, I feel quite a bit like I'm in Gaza right now, but never mind that. We can see here that we can go to the CRT Shack in 2024, and as a matter of fact, if you join the CRT Shack in 2024, what are you going to get? My friends, you will get a special roll, 2024, January only, 2024, if you join in the month of January 2024, you will get a special role in the CRT Shack. Click the link in the description below, my friends, and join this wonderful, wonderful server on Discord. See content like that on an almost monthly basis. But anyway, there you go. Steam still works perfectly, perfectly fine. So we can go over here, take a look at this. This is Office support. Of course, the best version of Office is 2007, which supports, I think, Windows XP, so obviously that's going to work, but it supports up to Office 2016, and obviously Office 365 will still work perfectly in browsers. Now, browsers, that's a very interesting point to come up isn't it, my friends? Let's take a look at browser support on Windows 7. I've made a comprehensive chart here demonstrating browser support for Windows 7 so far in 2024. This is up to date as of a few days ago, which is good enough for me, you know. It's not going to change after all. So, the best browser for Windows 7 right now, and probably for a long time, is going to be Firefox 115.0.2, which is the last version that supports Windows 7. It is from July of 2023, but all major browsers have ended support for it at this point, and anything claiming to support Windows 7 is just kind of, based on an older version of one of these browsers, most likely. Chromium ended support in January 2023, as you can see there, so all of those browsers will be at that point. And you might run into a problem with a specific website here or there, but for the most part, that's going to work perfectly fine. I have tested all of these out at some point. Edge ended support in December of 2022, so it's going to be the worst, but yeah. All of them still work perfectly fine as far as, 95% of websites probably. Anything you're going to use, YouTube, we can load up YouTube, that's kind of my go-to. I think I'm even logged in on YouTube on here, let's see, that'll be very interesting. It's a little slow on this, that's mostly because of my internet though, as we know. Yep, there you go, so Windows 7, Edge on Windows 7 still works fine. We can look at dashy, hilarious moments. I should probably mute the volume, okay. Scared me, though. I think I already had it turned down, so that was good. But yeah, you can see there, we can go full screen, perfectly fine. Laptop from 2009, no problem at all. We close that out. So here's Firefox. One website that I found by happenstance, because I happen to use Apple Music. One thing about it is that it does not work in Chromium browsers anymore that supported Windows 7. Was it version 109, I think? I found out that this specific website does not work anymore. I just realized that my recently played music is really embarrassing, so I got off of that. But yeah, I'll show you with my volume turned really low. I will show you that it still works just fine. Much better. You can see Apple Music works fine in Firefox. Last supported July of 2023, I think it was. June or July of 2023, the last browser that supported Windows 7 officially. So there you have it. Look at my miserable dashboard. What miserable failure of a YouTube channel. There it is, loads a little slowly. It's because it got dial-up internet. And there you have it. We can, we can open this up and still play Magnum P.I.'s Adventures in a Bad Neighborhood in Canada. A very good video game from 2014. Windows 7 chugging along just fine here. We can open this up. Somebody wishes me a Happy New Year on Steam, apparently. I thought I closed you, Steam. Just can't get enough of me, can you? These Steam friends, man, they really are clingy. But anyway, yeah, I mean, what else? What else do you want from me? Windows 7 is perfectly fine. LibreOffice. What's the latest version of LibreOffice? Is it 7.4? I don't know. Ooh, I'm going to have to censor that. That's not a good thing to show on the video. Ooh, yikes. OBS Studio. I'm pretty sure this is from, 2017, old version. But, I haven't even used it before. Well, wouldn't you know? I can't even tell you anything that doesn't work on it. I mean, I haven't found anything major. I mean, stuff, obvious stuff like Adobe, Creative Cloud doesn't work on it. And it did, thing in, 2020. But they ended support for that shortly after. I did try back in early 2021 putting it on Windows 7 machine, but yeah, by then it had already pretty much ended support. But you can still use CS6. That's, something you can remember. with older operating systems, you can use older software with it always. So, something to keep in mind if you're wondering about modern software working on these old operating systems, well, you can always install older versions. But, anyhow, that's pretty much all I have to say about Windows 7 in 2024. I know a lot of people are concerned about it not working, and, you know, the support for it will hold up a lot better than it did for Windows Vista, I think. Vista pretty much all went out the same time as Windows XP. Windows XP's support was excellent because I think still like 10% of all computer users were using it in 2016 or 17, I think. So, you know, they were still supporting it because they kind of had to. With Windows 7, its use share, whatever it is called, the percentage of people using it has dropped drastically over the last year. This has gone from about 10% or 11% down to 3%, as I showed earlier. So people are moving to Windows 10, not Windows 11. It's stayed about the same, and Windows 10 has actually gone up over the past year, which is kind of funny. So in 2025, it's going to be a pretty interesting story, isn't it? But for now, Windows 7, honestly, everything still pretty much works on it, except for really complex, you know, stuff like Adobe. Adobe specifically, I pick on them because they're really picky about your operating system and updates and keeping your stuff up to the minute of all that stuff. So, you know, have to pick on them a little bit, but they do make some good software. And I think it's about time for me to go take this footage to some of their software right now. So I thank you for watching this video in 2024, my friend. If you're watching this in 2027, please leave me a comment. Let me know why that is exactly. And, I would say I'm looking forward to 2024, but not really. Not really. Looking forward to using this laptop some more, though, so we can at least do that. I'll probably do another video on this thing if you're interested. Well, there you have it, friends. Happy New Year, and stay safe out there as much as you possibly can, at least.